Today we're gonna go over 5 versions of the same move, and they are all awesome. Whatever fitness level you are at, you can do at least one of them. The first version is in a bear crawl position. So have your knees underneath your hips and your hands underneath the shoulders. Curl the toes under, and all you do is you engage your lower abs. So we suck it in and lift up your knees and go back down. So that will be the first part of the version one. And if you can do this, if you can master the actual tuck, you're gonna add a step in. So you're tucking up, stay there, and then you step in and back. And this is awesome because you end up in something called a 3-point plank. When you're lifting up that foot, when you're right here, that means that you have to engage your transverse abs that wrap around your waist, and they will help you get really strong. The second version is the same as the first version. The only difference is that you're in an actual plank. But for a lot of people who are starting out, to be in a clean plank and not dropping their lower back, it takes a little bit of practicing first. So you're doing exactly the same as in version one, but you're just stepping in like this in a straightforward plank. And if you want to make this a little harder, when you're stepping in, you keep your foot off the ground. So you're hovering over the ground, and that will increase the difficulty level just a little bit. The third version is going into an actual inverted position. So you put your feet on a bench, a box, whatever you have available, and you're inverting yourself. So my shoulders are below the level of the hips. So now you have to fight gravity, and when you're stepping down, it makes it, again, a little bit harder, and you can do that same floating thing that you did in the straightforward plank. This is awesome, a great way to progress exercises that are on the floor. Now, if you have sliders or gliders or flex discs or anything like it available, love those tools. And if you don't, you can use socks on hardwood floor as well, or a towel on hardwood floor. They all work great. What I love about it is that you can add a downward motion and a traction to the whole exercise, and the movement becomes, again, more challenging. So when you're here and you're doing that tuck, you don't just go in and out, but you're also pushing down and dragging forward. So you push and drag, and you will feel those forces on your core, and they will really make a difference on your core strength development. If you have any kind of suspension trainer, this is the hardest version and awesome for those of you who are a little bit more advanced. So what happens when you're here, you have something called oscillation. You have an oscillation factor that makes this more challenging. And when you're doing your knee tucks, your body wants to swing in different directions, and you have to control that movement in your core and activate muscle fibers that you just simply can't when you're on the ground. So again, if you have this tool, I recommend you use it. I hope that these tips were helpful, and if you want to look further into my training, please head to www.thesweatboxinc.com.